my name is Rod. I'm with Greenstone. I'm the sales manager here.
Hi, my name is Amélie. I'm the owner and founder of EcoSynergy. We're an Alberta-based company. We do projects all over Western Canada, and we specialize in high-performance buildings.
Let's talk about energy modeling, Amélie. Let's talk about trying to reach efficiency as a whole picture versus components, because often as a high-performance building product supplier, we find ourselves with contractors particularly who look at our product and say, wow, this product's amazing. I'm just gonna seal the panels and stuff like the manufacturer tells us to, and don't need to worry about too much else because it should automatically be way better than traditional wood construction. So maybe they become a little careless in some of the transition details between floors and roofs and windows and doors and stuff like that. And so we find ourselves challenged sometimes with not getting the air changes per hour that we're hoping for. We run into situations where they're coming back with similar results to wood construction saying, hey, I thought we should be way tighter than this. What the heck?
So energy modeling is a tool, and it's a tool that has great, great information in it. And it gives us a leg up on what we need to plan for ahead. That's the glory of an energy simulation model used as a tool when understanding what comes out of it.
Right. Okay. So you can use an energy simulation model to properly size your furnace, your air conditioner, your air makeup unit, to find out operational cost impacts of different performing walls, windows and doors,
yeah.
Operational cost impacts of different components.
That's right.
Plus how comfortable that occupied space is going to be for the occupant as well. Because if you've got improperly sized equipment, we run into short cycling, we run into inefficiencies in, and even premature equipment failures because they're sized wrong.
That's
and
right.
Possibly somebody spent two times as much money on equipment than
that won't work. Right.
Just an example, I guess. I've got a client who built a house with Greenstone, and it was actually a multi-unit senior care home facility.
Okay.
And so he called me one day, super concerned. He said, Rob, I thought these walls were supposed to be so efficient. I said, so they are efficient. What are you talking about? Well, I've got the mechanical guy telling me that I need two 90,000 BTU furnaces, I need two HRVs, I need this, this, this. He says, that's crazy, that's insanity. It's only a 3,800 square foot building. I says, okay, well, this is the point in the conversation where we bring in an energy advisor. We get the modeling done, we get them to run your calculations, because most likely your mechanical guy just said, based on the square feet, here's what you need. We ran the energy simulation model for the build, and he ended up only putting in one furnace that was 45,000 BTUs.
So half.
A quarter.
A quarter.
Right?
Right.
So 290s, 290s to 145, and then one HRV that was also correctly sized. So the money he saved on mechanical equipment paid for his wall package.
Totally. That's what cost trade-off is.
That's trade-off. So now he's in a building that uses less than half of a comparable build for the same client. Actually, his is larger than the other build. Same application, same occupancy, a little higher occupancy than the other build. And he's got, I think the utility operational cost is less than half of the other building. And he did it for a lower cost. So that's what energy simulation modeling can help us with.
Yes, an EcoSynergy thing, that's what we do in our group. That's why we do a lot more than just crunching numbers.
Right.
Like we look at them and then we make recommendations. Now if the builder, client, whoever chooses to do that or not, that's up to them.
Right.
But we don't want to not tell them, because we feel that as consultants, that's what we should be doing. We believe that groups that do scopes of work like us, like energy consulting or, you know, any kind of consultancy, should be held to the same kind of service level as lawyers and accountants do.
Right.
If you run into something with the city or on site, you should be able to call us and we will help you
get sort through
that's
whatever.
Yes, because we speak the right lingo.
That's right.
Right? It is kind of a, it's not a new thing because it's been around since the 80s.
Yeah.
But it's a new scope for many.
Yeah.
And there's a big difference between theoretical lingo, site lingo, yeah, homeowner lingo, and then comfort lingo.
Of course.
Right? We all talk about the same thing, but we're not speaking the same language. So that's what energy simulations can do.
Thanks guys for joining us today. It's been great to have you, Amélie, and pick your brain on all these different things with our conversations that we had. Thanks for the information and coming all this way to Brandon, Manitoba.
Yeah, no, call me anytime. I love when people pick my brains. I put a lot of money in this brain, so let's share it.